Hey guys, what's going on? It's Dokkan here, and today we are going to be doing a fun video. Today is going to be a guesstimate of who is going to be the new TEQ Extreme leader, the TEQ 120 leader. And as you can see by my screen, I really apologize first off about how discombobulated they all are. I am doing this all within my video editor. This is not being done inside of a photo editing program whatsoever. So that's why all these guys do not look lined up pretty nice and everything like I typically like to do. But I just wanted to do this for fun. So essentially what we're going to do, I have listed all of the leaders ever since the first Dokkan leaders came out. That is the flat boost leaders with a three key addition. That is the top line. As you see, I have all five different elements and the Gogeta, which was added in. And then I have the 100% leaders underneath them. Then I have the 70% leaders, the 90% LRs, and I have the 120 leaders that are currently out. I have all of them listed here. So let's quick talk about all this. So if we see in terms of how things have progressed, we have two, in terms of the supers, let's talk about that first, just to get that off the table. We have the Agility Super Saiyan 3 Goku, and we have the TEQ version of him, which is now the 120 lead for our TEQ team. In terms of Gogeta, we got a new Gogeta, and we have not gotten a new Ultimate Gohan in terms of a leader anyway. So those are the three originals that have come. We have the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku, which he does not have, not even the God Super Saiyan God Goku, he does not have a leader at this point in time. And we have the Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta, who does. So I guess technically the Kaioken Blue is technically the Goku Blue. You can go with that, but it's technically Kaioken. Though, even though it's kind of specific, a specialty, we do have the two Super Saiyan 4s, the Goku and the Vegeta. They are the 120s. But anyway, that's just going over the heroes. We do see a small pattern there where we have a couple that were rehashed, which is actually the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks and the Super Saiyan 3 Goku and the Intelligence Gogeta. So let's go ahead and take the supers off the table as of for right now. All right, so with all the supers that are currently off the table, let's go ahead and take a look. So we can definitely see a small trend here. Well, first things first, we have Broly is all across the board. Broly doesn't have 100% lead, but Broly has the flat out boost, the original strength one. He has the 70% physical lead and the 90% LR. There is currently no TEQ version of him whatsoever. So he is actually, you know what, guys, I hate to say it because I know some of you guys are not big Broly fans, but we technically have him on the table for being a possible villain. And again, this is in terms of villains that are currently there. We are not discussing villains that are not currently out as leaders. There are a couple of them out there. I know there's been so a couple people have said Hildegard. I think that'd be hilarious, but no, I don't think that's going to be a thing. You never know, Baby might be one. We still haven't done Garlic Jr., so that could be one. Maybe, who knows? There could be a couple. You know what? Let me ask you this. Down in the comments below, who do you think is going to be the next villain? Before we start, put down who you think is going to be the next villain. I don't want to have my influence about what I think is going to happen. I mean, you could use this board that I have put up so if you want to. But let's go ahead and let's start a discussion about that. Now, with that being said, I'm not going to be using any villains that have not already been created as leaders. So let's go ahead and talk about it. First off, we have the Goku Black. Now, personally, I don't think they would make Goku Black a leader. That's just based off of the meta of the game. Goku Black was specific to the villains team. So that is also why I did not put Vegito Blue or merge Zamasu or the Enraged Trunks or Super Saiyan Rose, specifically because they were for villain lead and hero leads. So I didn't really want to include them in on this because I think they are going to keep them as a specific type of leaders. Who knows? They may not be. But in terms of the meta of the game, I feel like Bandai would go that route. If you don't believe, if you don't think that, then let me know. I mean, I wouldn't mind seeing a TEQ version of Super Saiyan Rose. Another reason why I don't think Goku Black would be the TEQ villain lead is because, well, he has the TEQ version that is farmable from the event. So that kind of technically makes him ineligible for being a leader. So now we also have to take into consideration Buhan. Well, there's technically Kid Buu, who is an intelligence leader, and you have the Buhan as well. But do you really think that Bandai is going to make Buhan a leader if they already have a Kid Buu? I feel like they wouldn't do that. I personally, me thinking, I don't think that they would do a Buhan because they're not going to have a Buhan and a Kid Buu. I feel like they would have to mix it up. They're different types of leaders. So I'm gonna say personally, I think he's off the table. I don't think Buhan is on the table for this. I'm going to eliminate him. Now you have Super Android 17. I don't think that they're going to go ahead with an Android leader at that point. So I would take the Super Android 7, well, obviously Android 17. I would take the two Androids out from there because they're not, again, I don't think they're going to have two different Androids. So that's taken off the table, in my opinion, anyway. So that removes him. Now we have the Buhan and the Kid Buu removed, and the Goku Black removed. That leaves us with a couple others. So we already have a tech leader for Golden Frieza. He is the 100%, so they can't rehash him as a tech villain. So that takes Golden Frieza out of the equation. We have Korra, but let me tell you, that doesn't mean that they won't do a full power Frieza. Now, Korra and Frieza are different characters. I personally, my thing is, I would rather have a full power Frieza. I think they should do something a little bit different. If they were to choose him, I think that this last one should have a unique new ability. Like, maybe keep the immense damage, well, obviously keep the immense damage modifier. You could probably have a passive skill that has like 120% or whatever it is, because I know that the physical one's 120% when Dokkan Awakened. But have something cool, like, where his super attack at a certain level, like at 11, is like his version of the Kienzan, where the next round it has a chance of coming back and doing additional damage because you know what? He can control it. But but outside of that, that's just whatever. I think that it could be the full power Frieza. Now, it can't be Cell, in my opinion, because they already have the tech Cell, so he's off the table. And it can't be a new Majin Vegeta because they already have a tech version of him. And Janemba is already a card, so they won't rehash him. So, what does that leave us with? That leaves us with a full power Frieza, an LR Broly, and an Omega Shenron. I'm gonna pause real quick. I decided after editing this video that I'm going to add Buhan back in as an educated guess for a villain. Just because, okay, so I was okay with having a Korra and a full power Frieza, and I'm okay with having the two Super Saiyan 4 Gokus. I should think that they would probably do a Buhan. A Buhan doesn't have a third stage. So I can see them adding Buhan in. So I just wanted to edit this into the current video. I'm going to have Buhan in as a valid, viable leader for our tech lead. But yeah, let's jump back into the video. Sorry for that interjection. Those are the cards that are up to be the 120 lead. Now, what do you guys think? Again, now this is just again basing off of old villains that are currently available as leaders and who they could possibly make into a rehashed version of themselves. I would love to see new full power Frieza. I'm so sick of the golden Friezes. Now, another reason why I think that it could be a full power Frieza is because on his event specifically, the Evil Emperor of the Universe, he doesn't have a third level, at least a level that drops 7 medals. So I could definitely see that being a thing. I mean, Omega Shenron already has his out there. I mean, don't get me wrong, they could just add another level onto the Omega Shenron one, which will drop in a different type of 7 medals. But I think that full power Frieza is long overdue, in my opinion, only because he hasn't been rehashed at all. He's the only card of his type as well. But again, you know what? Let me know what you guys think in the comments below now that we went over all of this. Have you changed your mind about who you think is going to be the next leader? Do you think I'm correct? Would you like to see full power Frieza? But that's it, guys. That's just through process of elimination. If you guys think it's not going to be someone on the list, if you don't think it's going to be a rehash of an existing villain, who do you think it's going to be? And thanks, guys. Thank you for joining me here today. Hope you enjoyed this video. You all have a good day, and I will catch you in the next one.